Joining us this evening are our guests, Rajiv Dogra, former diplomat, joining us from Delhi. Good evening, Mr. Dogra. Retired General Shankar Roy Chaudhary. Good evening, sir. Former Army Chief. And he's joining us from Kolkata. Brigadier V. Mahalingam joining us from Delhi, defense analyst. Also, good evening to Air Vice Marshal Abid Rao, who joins us from Karachi. Good evening, Air Vice Marshal. And we are also waiting for Lieutenant Colonel Shafkat Saeed to join us from Islamabad in a short while from now. But the first question to Air Vice Marshal Abid Rao. Here is a man who's being tried for treason. Here is a man who should be tried again for saying he's a Sindhi first, Pakistani later. India is not going to take him seriously. Will Pakistan?
Well, he's being tried for treason not because of doing anything against Pakistan. That's an internal matter. People call it a political revenge because he overthrew a political government. Under Article 6, he's being tried. And I don't think there is much strength in the case against him. But anyway, time will show that. He is an army general. He has commanded Pakistan Army. He has been the president of Pakistan for 9 years. And he knows his strength. He knows India's strength. And he has debated Kashmir issue with two very honorable prime ministers of India, Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee and Mr. Manmohan Singh. And both have agreed that there is a problem that needs to be resolved. Three of them are still alive. Three of them have confirmed that they were very close to a solution when their term finished in their offices. Now, India, for last, say, few months, is in a greater sense of denial by reacting to the word that Kashmir is a problem. I don't want to go into details of the history, but I have refreshed my knowledge on Kashmir issue by a book written by Jaswant Singh, India at Risk. He has, in a very neutral manner, described the behavior of the two governments and their wrong handling of the situation, that a problem continues 67, 68 years after the independence. Now, Pervez Musharraf is not irrelevant. Bilawal Bhutto is not persona non grata. Our prime minister is also, I mean, I'm hearing this word at Indian media that he was snubbed by the Indian prime minister. I think that's a very poor description of the speeches of two prime ministers. Mr. Narendra Modi also admitted that Kashmir issue is a bilateral issue. Right. That means there is an issue, but that is a bilateral issue. So your army chief can make any hostile statement and you should not react.
With all due respect, and I'm going to bring in our other guests also on this, that the issue is not about what is relevant and what is not relevant. It is about who is ranting and who is raising this scare rhetoric. Pervez Musharraf is at a time when he does not know whether he can leave the country or not. And Rajiv Dogra,
say the same thing.
Yeah, I'll come across to you on that also. And we will take this discussion forward. There are relevant issues. But are these relevant people who are talking and who are raising this issue? Rajiv Dogra, Subramanian Swamy, has he called Pervez Musharraf's bluff when he says he's an intelligent man and he's playing politics? He's raking this issue only to play politics in Pakistan.
Well, I hope he is an intelligent man. If he was really intelligent, then he wouldn't have come back to Pakistan knowing that there's a charge of murder and a charge of sedition against him. In fact, his own army decided to abandon him. General Kayani refused to touch him. Then there are other veterans like Hamid Gul, the former ISI chief, who goes on openly bad-mouthing Pervez Musharraf. But what is really worrying for Pakistan and also for India. And here I'll just digress a little. And I would really not take seriously our guest from Pakistan because he's an honorable man, he's an honorable military man, and he has to defend a former army chief. So I wouldn't take his defense seriously. But what worries me greatly is the advantage that Pervez Musharraf is taking of his friend's brother. His friend who died in 1971 war, again called Mr. Sharif, his friend's brother who happens to be the current army chief, he seems to be doing backseat driving for the current army chief, and that is dangerous. That is dangerous for the Pakistan army, and that is dangerous for Pakistan-India relations, because Musharraf would want to raise up the temperature so that the attention gets diverted from him and his cases have an easier handling. That is his single point agenda as far as his own stay in Pakistan is concerned, that somehow his cases get dismissed.
So
that is why he's raising the temperature.
Right. Mr. Dogra, just pause there and we'll go across to Shafkat Saeed, who also joins us from Islamabad. So very clearly, Parvez Musharraf is playing politics. And no matter, you have on record with me on this show, Colonel Shafkat Saeed said there was no military involvement as far as Kargil conflict was concerned. Pakistani military involvement was not there at all. You have said this on record here. And here you have Parvez Musharraf. How are you going to defend a man who says it was a military success which turned into a political defeat? So here you have your ex-president saying, yes, the Pakistan military was involved in the Kargil conflict. Now, how do we take this man seriously when he says Kashmir is in national interest?
Say Pakistan army was not involved in the war. There's a war between Pakistan and Indian armed forces in Kargil. How do you say that Pakistan army was not involved in that? And your rhetoric of that army is managing everything and Parvez Musharraf is doing backseat driving, this is irrelevant. And I think Parvez Musharraf saying...
How is it irrelevant, sir? How is it irrelevant?
Army, he's not an army spokesman. He's no more, he has, the only connection that he has with army is that he is an ex-army chief. And now he's in politics. Like
he's in army and the backing of the army, the real reason why he even dared to come back to Pakistan in the first place. Whether it is a mistake or not is the other question. He's trying to bat for the army and become the army's mouthpiece so that he hopes that that will help him stay away from the courts because the courts are going to take him to trial. The hearing is scheduled.
No, sorry. I don't agree with this because he has nothing to do with the opinion of the army. And your, for example, the things keep happening and you see that wherever you can coin your concept and your motives there, you start saying things trying to malign Pakistan army. This is not correct. Pakistan army has nothing to do with...
Sir, 10 violations in 4 days, ceasefire. The shelling has happened on our people on this side of the border from Pakistan. It is civilians, one girl, 10 people have been injured. And your ex-president says that don't test the Pakistan army's resolve. Now, how do you take that seriously, sir? And Brigadier Marlingham, I'm just going to bring in our other guest also, Colonel Shafkat Saeed. So please bear with me. I will come back to you.
I will answer this question.
Yeah, go ahead, sir, first. I'll go to Brigadier Marlingham after that. Yes, Colonel Shafkat Saeed. Yeah.
I'm speaking to you on this media, which does not report any casualties which take place on Pakistani side. There were about 2-3 deaths and 7-8 injured once in a border violation on the working boundary opposite Sialkot and Jammu, between Sialkot and Jammu. There were no mention of Pakistani casualties on any of Indian channels. This is one side reported.
You should be
on the casualties which take place between, and this is a routine activity on the LOC. Please don't create alarm on this. It is a ceasefire.
We will create, Colonel Shafkat Saeed, ceasefire violations are ceasefire violations. And if the shelling is happening, up to 120 mm of shelling is happening from that and from that side, it is a serious matter. And why is it happening only on these last 4 days? Why is it happening just before the winter sets in, Brigadier Marlingham? Isn't there a sinister effort? Are we sending people across the border to foment terror on Pakistani soil or is it vice versa?
Absolutely no. I would like to put certain things on record. The Pakistani...
Shafkat Sahab, I'll come across to you. Please wait on. Please wait on. Yeah. Yes,
I would like to put certain things on record. Pakistan Colonel just now mentioned that the war was between Pakistan Army and Indian Army. The Pakistan Army kept telling right through the Kargil War that it was a war between the Pakistani Mujahideen and Indian Army. To that extent that Pakistan Army refused to even take the dead bodies of the Pakistan soldiers who were lying there. He cannot deny that. Secondly, let me remind him that as far as this thing is concerned, Musharraf is concerned, Admiral Bukhari, who was the chief of the naval staff at that point in time, has openly demanded that Musharraf should be tried by a tri-court-martial or by a tri-service court-martial. This is what he has demanded. Now, as far as the Pakistan's, this thing is concerned, let me very categorically say, the Bilawal Bhutto was trying to get an entry into politics, whereas Bhutto is trying to get an exit from India, both by trying to become popular with the masses and trying to fool them in the bargain. That precisely is what is happening.
Right. Colonel Shavkat Saeed and Vice Marshal, Air Vice Marshal Abid Rao, I will come across to you. Please wait on. I just need to bring in, General Shankar Roy Chaudhary. He's been patient enough all this while to listen to all the others. General Saab, your reaction to what Parvez Musharraf has said, and does he have any locus standi? One. And two, should we allow such people to continue ranting like this just so that they remain relevant in Pakistani politics and within the Pakistani system, or to further their own gains, this India bashing? Should it be tolerated?
Indian bashing.
See, Parvez Musharraf has this old habit of shooting off his mouth. And I don't think one should pay any attention to what he says. He keeps saying different things at different times, even when he was in the service. So, this chap, Parvez Musharraf, as a brigadier, he attacked Siachen three times. He had heavy casualties on all three occasions. And in any other army, he would have been sacked. I do not know what the internal politics of the Pakistan army were at that time, but Musharraf was allowed to continue. Why is for the Pakistan and the Pakistan army to go into? My contention is, of course, one should get no credence to what General Musharraf is saying, and what these gentlemen were speaking about backseat driving may or may not be correct. I am not in the know. But my concern is, why are these incidents happening at this time? At this time, why at this time? Why at this time? Especially when the vultures are gathering. You've got ISIS, you've got Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan, and you've got Al Qaeda setting up shop in India. So why are these incidents happening at this particular time? Is there something behind it? I think people should go into it. It's not a mere ceasefire violation as it appears to be. If people get shot at, they will shoot back. That's been happening for a long time. But is there any deeper significance of these incidents happening at this time when the vultures are gathering visibly in Pakistan?
And very, also very relevant question, sir. Very relevant question you've raised. Air Vice Marshal Abid Rao and Lieutenant Colonel Shavkat Saeed, I'll come across to you. First, Air Vice Marshal, go ahead, please. You had a point to make, and also, do you agree or disagree with the timing of these ceasefire violations happening? Well, if there is shelling, there will be return fire.
Okay, first of all, if the Indian stance is only to be projected at media like this, then I would suggest one thing, that if India is so sincere about peace, let a third party say who fires the first bullet at the LOC. We have the UN observers. India declines to give them any place. India makes the accusation, believes itself, and wants us to believe that. We have done it for a long time. Now let's get serious about it. And I have a lot of regard for General Shankar Roy and his opinion. I respect that. If we both want peace, there is a way. But if it is through this kind of bashing and one-sided allegations, we will reach nowhere except provoking each other more and more at the border. You see, if you think Mr. Bilawal Bhutto, Mr. Parvez Musharraf want to gain relevance by raising Kashmir, then you should also understand that it is because Kashmir is an issue with every Pakistani. You talk to anybody on the street, they will tell you that it is an unresolved issue. Whatever way it gets settled, it may not be the type which Pakistan expected in 1948. It may be division, it may be resting at your own side along the LOC. But let's come to some agreement. By accusation, the fact that you have 500,000 strong army there means there is some problem that you also see. On 26 January, on 15th August, there is a shutdown strike in Kashmir. Who does that? Is it Pakistan?
There is an issue. Who backs that? It is Pakistan.
Sir, you, is Pakistan. You believe that?
Absolutely. There is support. You cannot deny that the support, the terror camps, the people who get training to try and foster militancy, it is happening in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. And they do it brazenly. And Pakistan is not doing anything to curb that. The establishment, be it the army, the government is not doing enough. So in that case, when you have an ex-president coming back and saying...
This is what you are saying. What if I don't believe it? I am saying that let a third party decide. If you don't trust us,
correct.
We don't
and
trust
we also hope we also so hope that the people of Pakistan don't believe somebody like Parvez Musharraf. They don't believe somebody who says that I'm a Sindhi before I'm a Pakistani, and he stands there and talks about national interest because he's putting his own origins first before the country itself. So why will somebody take him seriously? That's the other question, sir.
People have the wisdom to judge a relevant leader from an irrelevant leader. So leave that to internal dynamics of Pakistan. But the fact is that if there is a problem, let the local army commanders meet. Let Ministry of Foreign Affairs.
Sir, those meetings happen. But what happens is soon after the flag meet, there is a ceasefire violation. Now that is what is happening. So we don't know who is not serious or who does not want to talk at all. Or is it that somebody says let's talk and there is somebody else who says no, there is no way there can be talk. No, no way there can be any ceasefire. It has to be violated because
Indians have to be pushed
through.
Pakistan is, believe me, if Pakistanis and Indians meet regularly, these groups will get defeated on their own.
Sir, you said Pakistanis and Indians.
I'm serious.
Separatists don't count in that. So then Pakistan has to choose who they want to
they
meet.
Don't
sir,
count.
Sir, on that note, please hold your thoughts. Brigadier Malingam, General Shankar Roy Chaudhary, Colonel Shafkat Saeed, please hold your thoughts. I have to take a short break. We'll pick it up after the break.